tells you these are impossible. To have them all stacked up in this type of portfolio, nobody chooses these words. You know, it's like the demon thing. People say in every movie, it's the demon's fault. It's the devil's fault. It's the demon's fault. It's the devil's fault. I assure you, if you look at a demon's sigil and you look at a disc that you place your target church, you'll see that the blood is over there, you know, the body, so that you can write the demon sigil on there. And that blood is just like the supposed to be the menstrual blood, like Jesus the Son, Mithra, ripping the menstrual blood into this black hole sun, because it's on loop. It has to be on loop, because you can't bottle energy up. You're in a contained area where you can't confine energy, so it has to be able to loop. That's why these symbols are rubbing your face. That's why it's 666 or 999. It's the, like the two ball cane. When people hear this two ball cane, listen, I don't beat around the bush. My mother's maiden name is King. My last name is Braun. I mean, the first to be guardian of the Grail, and my mother's name to be Cain, and we need to be seven generations removed from this inbreeding royal class that came out of, or was thrown out of Eden. Now here we are. This is like impossible shit. It's not like, it doesn't matter what anybody believes. It was always, what did you intend to do about it? Like I say, go play guinea pig. Run off to the Garden of Eden without your Don, you know, who's telling you, open up the book, be 141,000. You know, if it takes 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, I mean, you waited this long, and now you have the information. You're the sealed elect. You're going to live somehow. Just lay low, stay out of trouble. You know, don't try and be a big shot and do, you know, I just want to be a fucking lowly plumber. In a work truck, go into a place. I mean, literally, you can't fuck with me, because there's nothing illegal about being a plumber and going to work every day and being a good father and husband. Is there anything illegal about this? You can't complain. Why is Satan not driving the road right, living in a giant house? That ain't the meek, and that meek is what inherits the earth. I don't need a castle. You want your fucking castle. When I come back from this Fountain of Youth Garden, I mean, I assure you, I'll be building motherfucking castles for everybody, and I'll be the last one to sleep in a castle. I'll be sleeping in a motherfucking treehouse, like you see on that Treehouse Master. You know, something up in the trees, like Ewoks or something, you know, from like Star Wars. I think I needed a big castle or something. I mean, it's kind of cool, I guess, but I think most of us are more modern. We'd rather be in like some sort of modern type of thing rather than some old Rocky type castle. I mean, I think you have to barricade yourself in to protect you from the people around you, because you're a piece of shit. They can't shoot the deer and feed themselves, because that's the king's deer. They can't do this. They got to give up 10% of their crops or whatever, everything, to use the landlord, the lord of the land, you know. You respect my authority type shit. This is like, look, a royal proclamation goes out, nobody rises up. It becomes like natural type order type shit. Like when I went on Flat Earth, British Flat Earth after party, and came out and showed you, I'm saying, y'all laugh. I told you all, what I was doing was stealing the elemental powers of Satan, the devil, you know. It's all about the blood. You need to put up that spiritual currency. What I'm saying is, people don't have enough spiritual currency in their veins to overturn this type of shit. You'd have to be like, going back to like when you're 18 and you've been donating, nonstop, every freaking 60 days. And it'd be gallons upon gallons of blood, and not really realizing what was going on until you take these certificates and then put them up physically as the Prince of Darkness, and in the description, the Antichrist. Here is the extension of the Grand Architect to free everybody from the chains of time and money. Who says this shit? Like, you know what I mean? You have to come to realization. your bloody shaman ain't gonna fucking tell. Your president ain't gonna say none of that. Nobody says this shit. Only you'd have to be the devil standing here on blood to say the type of shit I'd say. Like, it's clear who holds the spirit of destiny. It's clear who is the spirit of destiny. The angel doesn't get fired. All this shit. Yeah, I leave for heaven and next shit. This is impossible fucking shit. It goes on and on and on and on. What is the chance of that? Now, everybody around me, they see it. Everybody leaves me alone. Everyone wants it to just roll forward because it becomes too deep. Or if you think it's all by chance, one or two reversals, like when I say, God loves you, God bless you, I love you. Those three right there should have blown your freaking mind out of the way. That was literally me decapitating your fucking God. Don't you dare say, God loves you, I love you, God bless you. We shall die. But you still do it. I guarantee. Every time somebody needs blood, blah, blah, blah. Every time you see somebody that you worship, that you hold dear, you still say this shit. I don't say that shit because I know every word I speak is a magic spell. You went to grammar school to learn the Book of the Dead. You're in the land of the dead right now. Everybody around you is legally dead. You think I'm a magician? I'm a sorcerer? You went to grammar school to learn your motherfucking Book of the Dead. Every word you speak is a magic spell. You have your angle and degree of stupidity. Now, you're in a foreign land. You have no rights as such. What I'm saying to you is you couldn't stump a judge. Even if I showed you how to, you would be scared when the judge flipped out on you. Or you wouldn't keep your cool. You wouldn't understand that you're the king of the court. And that is a public motherfucking servant over there. And this is like law of the sea type shit. And, you know, I fly my colors pure because pirates only get away with pirating ships because they fly their Jolly Roger. Their colors clear. I tell you, flat out, who I am, I'm taking over the world. Blah, blah. This is flying your colors clear. It's not illegal. It's like you have to do this. You know, like somebody, they come up, they're the Antichrist, you know, they make funny videos. You know, if I didn't spell it out for you, you'd still be a motherfucking Jesus or a Buddhist or a Protestant because of the blood. Don't put your blood on it. Jesus put his blood up for you. Motherfucker, they stole your soul from under foot of birth. Your soul, your money says in God be trusted on a separation of church and state. Do you understand what I'm saying? It's separation of church and state. But your leaders swear on a fucking Bible. Okay? Don't tell me about separation. The CIA stands for the Catholic Intelligence Office. It's ran by Jesuits. They got the whole fucking city of, like, Langley where they can set up all kinds. They have all kinds of shit they can set up. Everybody is, like, somehow convinced that what they're doing is the right thing to do for whatever money that they make working with this organization that's supposedly trying to protect us from some, like, if you really think Kim Jong-un or any of these other motherfuckers out there are a threat to the United States, that's kind of funny. The biggest threat to the United States is you for not doing anything. You're supposed to be bloodthick with your countrymen. Natural. You're going to go stand side by side with them. We go to war. Die beside them, but you can't stand here. Before war, just unite peacefully. Bloodthick, bound in truth. This is, no, so flippy sickening. Being the devil isn't as glamorous as people like, but I can tell you this. Nobody enters the House of Living Waters before Satan. And if you think Admiral Richard Byrd and Sonny, this is kind of fun. He went there as the fucking postmaster and was rejected. He went there to open up. Like, you can't mail a letter out to somebody until there's a postmaster that set up some sort of communication where you have a zip code. You know what I'm saying? So if you wanted to mail a letter to Shambhala or a package or whatever, there would have to be that postal service in there, which is part of that intelligence. Anything that, look it up, the mail service, they don't fuck around. They're, you're gridded up. You have a telephone number that they can track. You have your social security number, you track, you have a fucking address, you have credit cards, it doesn't, it, like, you're on the run, they tell you, don't use your cell phone, don't use your credit cards, you literally, might as well, if you're white, shave your head, if it's not already shaved, and paint yourself black. I mean, just get a new identity, this type of shit, an identity, you know? What I'm saying is that, let me see your ID. This is flipping to me, being asked to see my ID. It's like, that should flip you out. Show me your identification, you know? And on it's got your name, your address, your this, your that. It's, they've got you cornered up in so many different ways. They got your medical records, they got your education records, they know your birth records, who's part of your family tree. If you want to know why they, it doesn't matter what church, it's all abundant life, this type of shit. But none of them get any life. You've been reading this Bible for so long, and you haven't gotten any smarter. Now I stumble and say, look, Jesus can't save you. They tell you clearly right over here, 2 Corinthians 4:4. And it's for a reason, because Jesus turns out to be the motherfucking Son, and the Son of God. So to think that anybody can grasp into this shit, it would take them years. I mean, it's the Kundalini type shit. Yeah. I don't believe it's really. That's fun. You get horny, hungry, a pain in your heart, or in your throat, you get a headache, your scalp, you got your soles of your feet, 2 below you. You have your angel wings at 3 above you and your halo. This is, it's, I'm telling people, where did you begin? It's like the pineal gland thing. You want to open up your pineal gland? How did you calcify your pineal gland? Let me tell you how to get to calcify your pineal gland. Give worship. And everybody's like the dearest to you, you know, like you hold people dear. It's like, I hold everybody dear around me. Every, yes, sir, thank you for my opportunity to serve. It's literally, it's okay. This is the one thing, is I hold everybody around me dear. And, you know, I want no soul left behind anybody. Everybody else, you know, it's like how many people, like this week on the job, I made a video showing my middle finger was cut like today, and you'll see it in the video today. It was like in the same spot, and I wiped it on my leg, and I said, I intend to bring forth heaven, and everybody was around me, and everybody flipped out about it, because I've already acclimated, you know, I acclimate people quick to who I am. I told you can't be a vampire. They say if you're a vampire, you can't cross the threshold of like people's homes or businesses type of shit. You know, tell them that this is the type of being you are. Listen, do you swallow that demon sigil front and back, you made your blood, like I say, and my wife got a bag of these, you know, demon biscuits that you eat at church from the online. Yeah. She, I kind of work, I seen her blood from her vagina on front and back and every demon sigil you can imagine. Somehow she pulled it off by the time I left from work, the time I got home. And ceremoniously ate them all. And for me to publish that type of shit is biblical. It's like, I could do shit nobody could do. For me to publish that shit would be too scared. You would know the end of days was really here. You might spontaneously human combust with like some biblical shit. Maybe you might duplicate it. Your wife would agree to it. And if she did, you'd be like Satan, the devil himself, with some mythical powers running through you. You're like, you know, take over the universe. Fuck everybody. I'm going to get you eternal life, whether you like it or not. You're going to live forever, get entrance into the Garden of Eden. You're going to be like biblical. You're going to wake up above the dome with your Father in heaven, whatever the fuck it is you cling to. You ain't getting there without putting your blood up beside me, making the atonement for your filthy soul. Let's call it like it is. They don't call me the devil for no reason. This is scary for people, and it should be. We're talking about blood.
It is scary for them. That's why they talk so much shit about us. But, you know, I think it's even scarier for them to see that it's like growing like wildfire. Like, it's out of our hands, for sure.
Dude, the haters are the best advertisement. The fact that they even public videos seem horrible shit. That's the great thing. The more videos I see saying negative shit, the more people I see publishing blood over a text. All I can say to these people talking negative is you're the best advertising, and they don't pay you anything.
you know.
For heaven's like, sakes, I work with you. If I could get you in front of my court, I'd kiss your feet and thank you, for heaven's sakes.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's how it works. They're here for a reason too, you know?